What's up, YouTube? It's time to brew some beer. What I'm brewing today is the Captain's Ale. I made this recipe once before. I used a Liberty Cream Ale kit and I added 40 ounces of Captain Crunch to it. It turned out fantastic. This is version two. Two things that I had to change, I can't find just regular straight up Captain Crunch anymore. Everything's gone to Crunch Berries. So I ended up getting the 40 ounce bag of Captain Crunch Crunch Berries, and the Liberty Ale Cream Kit is no longer available. So I had to get what was close to it from the website, which was just a basic cream ale kit. There are some differences in the recipe between the two. Several of the grains were changed in this new kit. We're gonna see how it turns out. I'll be using the basic cream ale kit and then also the Captain Crunch Crunch Berries. And we'll see if we can get that same flavor and also the 6.6 ABV that we got last time. This is gonna be a fun one. This will be me running it with the full new Batcave Brewery brew house, including the electric controller and also milling my own grains. I have been working with the grain mill a little bit. I've been tweaking it. The last time my settings were a little bit too, my gaps were a little bit too wide. This time I think I might have erred in the overcorrection. I think my gap might be too low. My flow is still moving, but barely. And for such a basic grain grill, that kind of makes me think I need to open up my gas a little bit. Time to mash in. A little bit of water to this mash in per the recipe, because I know from making this last time you need more water for the Captain Crunch because it is going to absorb some of the water. Version two is Crunch Berries. Good beer. Now there's been much more of a temperature drop than there normally is, so I gotta wait for this to get back up to 150. Our step temperature is 150, which means this has to be 152. And we gotta wait until this hits 150 for us to actually be mashing in. I am noticing an issue with that low flow rate. I'm having to keep my hot water at 170 to maintain 148, 149 in the mash tun. And two times I have had to reverse the flow in order to push hot water in from the bottom to break up the cake. I've been stirring this probably every 5-10 minutes to keep everything flowing, but it's been very labor intensive. So yes, I overcorrected and my grains are way too fine. It's time for the mash out. But because my mash is like almost stuck, the sparge is almost stuck here, I can't get it up to the 170 mash out that it's supposed to be. So what I did was, I'm bringing my water up to 190, and then I'm gonna run it, the pump through backwards to push water in from the bottom underneath the mesh until I get enough water where it's flowing, and I'm gonna run it off and hope for the best. This just became even more of an experiment than usual because of the technical difficulties I've been having with this, with the flow, with the recirculation. I need a boil volume of 6.6. So we're gonna kind of do like a weird batch sparge here. I'm gonna start running off and prepping for boil. The advantage that I got is I'm gonna be doing back-to-back batches. I'm doing another batch tomorrow. So it gives me a fresh attack on fixing some of these glitches. And any of you guys out there who homebrew, you probably know already. As long as I get something that's drinkable and enjoyable, this is a success. It's only a failure if it tastes bad. I don't know if you guys can tell there, but that's pretty cloudy. And I think that this beer will clear, because normally they clear during fermentation and aging anyway. But that's just kind of a testament to the issues I had by grinding my grains too fine. The grain bed didn't get set well to make a good filter to one off nice clean beer. The show must go on. Despite the kinks and the hiccups that I had along the way, I'm starting my boil. I collected 6.67 gallons, which is what the recipe calls for, the original recipe, and that should boil off to about 5.5 gallons. I've developed a small leak in my high-speed deep sink. There goes our boil. We're gonna add our bittering hops, which is 1 ounce of cluster. All right, 15 minutes left of the boil. I'm gonna add the Werflick tablet, which we are gonna need because this is like boiled mud. I'll show you. And the wort chiller to get this thing sanitized. This hangs off the side like so. That is not clear beer. We're gonna see what happens here. I think that, or I'm hoping that it'll clear up between the Werflick tablet and the fermentation, but it's like we're boiling mud. It's the end of our boil. Get our whirlpool going and our chiller. Bubble, bubble, bubble. This is the next day, so as you can see, that fermentation is rowdy. It did come off cloudy, and I'm gonna see how much it clears up in fermentation. Obviously, it's going well, so I've got good hopes for this one. My original gravity was estimated at 1.38, but Beersmith can't calculate for 40 ounces of kid cereal. So we came in at 1.055, which is close to where we were on the original Captain's Ale. So I've got good faith that this is gonna come in with a high ABV. Now it's just a matter of if the flavor is gonna be as good as it was the first time I made it. I was a little concerned about the viability of this and how it was gonna, how the starting gravity was gonna be based on the issues I had with temperature. I'm really hoping that all the starch converted correctly. I might get some offset based on the fact that there's extra just simple sugars in there from the cereal. But we'll see what the flavor turns out like here when this thing finishes fermenting. Been fermenting for about 20 days now. The primary fermentation for this guy is 14 days. This one does need to go into secondary fermentation to clear it up. My original batch, I kegged it after I finished fermenting out, and I had constant clogs just from the amount of crud that's actually in this brew from the cereal. The best way for me to do this would be for me to let this one completely finish out. I'm at 1.01, but I need this fermenter. You might hear the pump going. I got the Christmas ale going behind me because I needed to get that thing going so that it would be aged and prepped for the Christmas season. Last time I tried to do a Christmas ale, the last minute, it turned into a New Year's ale because it was not done for Christmas. My diehard fans out there, I apologize for not being able to film the Christmas ale this season. As you could tell, I was running the day, working out, stuff like that while I was brewing the day. So anytime I had a lull, I was actually going to the gym or going out for a run or whatever. I didn't really have time to set up the camera and make the video. Just needed to get the beer done. Don't worry. I'll be back on my next lager batch. I've got a couple of lagers. I'm gonna try making a dark lager, like a black lager. I'm gonna try one of those, and then I'm gonna do another lager along with it since I'm gonna be taking up the fermenter for a long period of time. But between this guy and the Christmas ale and what I've got in there right now, I should be able to keep all three taps going on the Keyser bar while I am waiting for the next two batches to finish lagering. It's clearing up. I mean, it definitely ain't done. When you do this brew, it comes out super cloudy. But it is clearing up. It's a good day here at the Batcave Brewery. Captain's Ale has finished out fermentation. It is running really clear, which I'm very happy about because last time it was hazy even when I was pouring it, hoping that I don't get any chill haze. Get this in the keg and get it under some pressure so I can start carbonating it. My starting gravity was 1.055 and we finished out at 1.003. And it's just in time. I got three taps on my Keyser bar. I had one open tap, and that's what this guy was for. And of course, I got my Christmas ale going. But it's like they talk to each other. Because right after one keg went bonk, the second keg is about to go bonk. I'm gonna end up in that same situation that I'm trying to avoid of three taps and no beer. No. That tank is super light. It might have one more beer in there, if we're lucky. Put this on 25 PSI to force carbonate. And we're off. There it is in all its goodness, the Captain's Ale, version 2. This turned out fantastic. 6.9% ABV. The flavor between this one and the original, using the Captain Crunch versus the Captain Crunch berries, no noticeable difference. I think it's really just that it breaks down the sugars and the differences between the regular Captain Crunch and what's in those berries doesn't really matter for the recipe. I am really glad that I racked it again because, as you can see, it is coming out crystal clear. I mean, it's got a great amber look to it. None of the haze that I had in the original batch, and I'm not getting any of the clogs as it pours out. I am really happy with this recipe. In fact, I already ordered another kit of the cream ale, so I can get another one of these going as soon as my lagers are done. This is fantastic. Probably one of my favorite home brews that I make, and I will be trying to keep this on my tap on the regular. Cheers.